Well, we hadn't put up a video in a while, so figured we should show you what we're up to this Saturday. Look at her all laughing and stuff. You shy, Shiloh?
Yes.
Say hi to Mom. So anyway, Saturday morning, decided to go on a little wander. We are currently sitting on the Edmonds Kingston Ferry, waiting to like float on across to the island out there. Actually, it's not the island. I suppose that would be the peninsula. And then we're just going to take a run along the coast out towards, well, the tip of it. Probably won't go too far, but maybe we'll get you some cool scenery. Maybe we'll get you some seals and whales to check out. You never know it. You'll see when you get out there along the actual ocean coast. Anyway, just saying hello. We'll talk at you again in a minute. Welcome to Port Gamble, Washington. It's a cute little town. I just figured I'd run some video as we're driving through. Let you look at it. I do mean little. But isn't it like just kind of this quaint little feel to it?
Yeah, I like it.
Never actually stopped here. I just passed through it. It'd be kind of interesting one day if they're, you know, when COVID's over with.
Right?
Said we were headed over to the Olympic Peninsula. We decided to kind of extend our drive along the northern edge of it. Right now we're about 40 miles out of Nia Bay, which is the furthest northwest corner of the Olympic Peninsula. Should be pretty. It's very rainy. This road's kind of rough, as I'm sure you can tell by the video quality, but so far it's a nice drive. Anyway, flip the camera around, let you see a little more. Well, apparently coronavirus prevents people from going to the beach in certain spots, so we don't get to show you Nia Bay.
But we pulled off the road a ways back, wandering around out here to show you the purdies. See, there's purdies walking away in orange. So we're just a little bit shy of Nia Bay on the very northwestern tip of the Olympic Peninsula. What's kind of cool out here, as you guys have seen before, when you and Dad came out this way with me once upon a time, all the rock. A lot of the really cool ones are further up closer to the place we can't go, but there's some neat stuff over here too. Oh, this is going to be fun walking. Might find us some starfish and stuff hanging out in some of these pools. So that land straight across from you that you can see out in there, that is actually British Columbia. And so down here over Shiloh's head, it's hard to tell, but that land ends out there in the distance, and that's where we would get to the true ocean. But unfortunately we couldn't get down there because we got stopped by tribal police, told it's all closed. All right, I gotta walk rocks, so I'm gonna turn the camera off for a minute. Just a random ocean tide pool. I'm gonna film it for, let's give you 1 minute and see how many things you find alive when you watch this video. There's a lot. Here, let's give you a cheat shot. There's two fish and three hermit crabs there, right in that very screen. You find them?
Oh, down a lot too.
Oops, there we go. There he is. A weird looking creature in a way, huh? All right, Mom. So hopefully they're still here, but you know, we're out on the Olympic Peninsula, and one of the things that, you know, made Dad con me into taking you guys out here was the Roosevelt elk herd. It's one of the largest elk herds that sort of is still wild managed and out here. We're just flying down the road at like, 55 miles an hour, and I look over and there is a whole bunch of elk. So watch out in these fields. I don't remember exactly where they were, somewhere right after this corner we're on. There you go, they're out in the field.
know how well you can see them out there. But there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't know, there's a lot. Let's try and zoom. What are you doing, dude? It's elk. I was checking them out.
Somewhere over there, the sign Shiloh's head, too. See? There she is. Anyway, hopefully you could actually see the elk. It's always hard to judge when you're zooming on a digital camera because it gets all grainy and weird, but still, kind of cool. Whole bunch of elk. So does the journey end. Back at the ferry terminal. Isn't that a pretty sight? Okay, maybe not. We could give you an uglier sight. Ah! Here's a pretty one. Here. We'll get you a pretty one. Anyway, just wrapping up the video. Obviously, it's kind of getting late. I'm surprised it looks this light in the video. It's about 9 o'clock. So we drove pretty much all the way out to almost Nia Bay, which, as I mentioned in the previous like clip, it is the furthest northwestern corner of the peninsula. Unfortunately, the tribal police had the road blocked off and they're not letting anybody down to the actual bay. So we ended up going back up the road a little ways, found a place to turn out. That's where we got all the beach video shots and stuff for you. We left there probably about 6 and decided to make the run back. It's about 3 hours, 2.5 hours, somewhere in there to run out there. Just heading back to Seattle now, or I shouldn't say Seattle. I don't live in Seattle. I don't like Seattle. We live in Linwood. Don't like it either, but hey, it's better than Seattle. At least they haven't, you know, taken over a section of the city and declared it, like, not part of the United States, right? Yeah, look that up if you don't know what I'm talking about. It's kind of amusing. Anyway, signing out. I hope you enjoyed our drive today, and you'll probably get another one here in a little bit, because I think we're heading up camping next weekend. Anyway, talk to you later.